And that's about the purpose of your work.
Yes. Well, I first began really from a dream. I had a dream when I was living for 5 years in the mountains by myself. I'd made a retreat, a silent retreat for myself. And out of that retreat, I received this dream that I was to leave and go into back into the world and to work in a circle around the world. And the way I had worked for 10 years in California, working with environmental sculpture and community, and having performance and ceremony at the end of the completion of the sculpture. But the dream showed me that I was to make a change and to work around the planet. And that circle represented an experience that I had had right before I went to have my retreat, and it was really the reason for my retreat, and where I saw the world filled with light and this interconnected thread, web of life running through everything, connecting everything. And I really changed my life at that moment. And I went into retreat just to be able to integrate this experience in every simple act of my life, because I was living without facilities. I just found a broken down trailer in the top of Boney Mountain in California, and lived extremely simple, carrying my water, gathering food from the mountain. So when I went back into the world with this dream, I started just using the skills that I had used my whole life, which was art, and went to 12 countries following a parallel around the world, and created sculptures in these 12 countries. And now the second world wheel has developed a little more. We're really starting wisdom centers in each of the countries, both in Paguche and in here, with schools, a way of preserving the knowledge of the indigenous people, which I feel is very important for our planet right now, because they know how to live sustainably within their environment, and we have lost that knowledge, and it's bringing great destruction to our planet. And also, they have an intimate relationship with nature and really live the sacredness of that relationship, which we have also lost. And so I'm emphasizing the indigenous cultures and a way of preserving them by starting these schools, so that the children will keep their culture, and they're fast losing it once they go into the public schools, and they lose their language, and they lose the sense of their own identity. And so we're trying to support the cultures. And also, now it's really a community effort. It's grown larger. And Edie Hartshorn has joined me as her wonderful outreach and wonderful work with people in the community. And filmmakers are coming forth to document this, David Aubrey, a wonderful filmmaker. And so it really has become a community work. Although I'm still creating the sculptures, but it's expanded to be a wisdom center.
Could you describe, are you doing a sculpture in the Amazon, and could you describe